I've never seen such things happening in my life. We are almost in a global lockdown. Indian Railways has, I think, for the first time in my life, been completely shut. We have had another economic crash, and global economy seems to be going in recession. And the novel coronavirus is infecting a lot of people. Almost 192 countries are affected by it. There are only 195 countries in the world. Is this really such a big problem?
There is a lot of panic, for sure. And whether this is really such a big problem or not would be known in a couple of weeks. But of course, I do see that it's a huge disruption. And this has, this is changing many, many things. I also fear that it could be a huge problem also. And some people say that the virus may eventually infect to even up to 80% of people, or some people say up to 60% of population. And as the mortality rate is rising, earlier it was just below 2%, but now in many countries, even exceeding 5%. So as the mortality rate is increasing, mm-hmm. we don't know how it's going to unfold. Of course, it's something disrupting many, many things.
Do you think it's some kind of conspiracy by any particular country?
Yes, I do hear such talks, and they do pop up in my own mind. If it's a kind of biological warfare or just a media propaganda or something like that, if you look at the actual deaths, even on this date, they are not huge. The count is about, how much is this, 20,000 by now?
As of now, it's 25,000
people died in maybe in a month's time. Mm-hmm. So this is not a very large number. Mm-hmm. People die all the time, mm-hmm. and if you think of even our country, India, around 20,000 people die because of suicide every month. There are around 2 lakh suicide annually. There are around 500,000 or a million people dying out because of pollution. People die, and it's not a very large number. There are some statistics that every year, mm-hmm. because of flu, something around 3 to 6 lakhs mm-hmm. people die every year. Mm-hmm. So, looking at that number and the way it has now been controlled in China, mm-hmm. not many people dying, it really doesn't look a very large number from that viewpoint. And then you never know. There could be a second wave or whatever is coming. So anyhow, the panic is there, the disruption is there. Maybe we are preparing for a new kind of systems, arrangements. So there would be a change. And of course, there is one more very important thing. And that is this, that most of the people who are dying are the people having comorbidities. Mm-hmm. Most of them are either suffering from hypertension or diabetes or cardiac issues, mm-hmm. or taking immunosuppressants, mm-hmm. or are elderly, very, very elderly, mm-hmm. or mm-hmm. as is in the case of Italy, mm-hmm. people are smoking a lot. Mm. And their lungs are already compromised. Mm. So I would say most of the people were already at the verge, mm-hmm. were already at the edge, mm-hmm. and this virus had just given them a soft push, mm-hmm. and then they have fallen. Mm-hmm. So one thing that is definitely coming out of it is this, that we should take health on priority. Mm-hmm. There is absolutely no sense. Mm-hmm. in carrying the comorbidities, mm-hmm. carrying the diabetes, or carrying your hypertension, mm-hmm. or carrying your cardiac issues, mm-hmm. or continuing your smoking.
Mm-hmm.
There cannot be any better time than this mm-hmm. to quit smoking.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that is for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And if we look at the global pharmaceutical industry mm-hmm. and healthcare system, which I don't really like to call healthcare, I like to call that disease care,
mm-hmm.
because what you get in healthcare is how you manage your disease,
mm-hmm.
how you manage your blood sugar level, how you manage your blood pressure, not that mm-hmm. you become free of disease, become free of mm-hmm. the medicines.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, one solid take is this, that there is no point carrying any morbidity, mm-hmm. any disease condition, and we should have very strong health, very strong immunity.
Strong health and strong immunity, can it be achieved in short term? Is there anything that we can do to increase our immunity right now?
Actually, you cannot increase immunity in very short time, and neither you can get a robust health in a short time. But you can lose them. If you act foolishly, then you can lose your immunity and you can lose your health very fast, very, very fast. I mean, just carrying some stress and not sleeping properly, even for a few days, will put down the number of natural killer cells dramatically low, and you would be at the verge of infection.
So how to protect whatever immunity or health that we have right now?
Yes, I'll go to that, but I like to continue with the old question mm-hmm. a bit more. And sometime to me, it looks that the time for looking at the short-term solutions is over.
Mm-hmm.
We have been for very, very long been fixing very short-term things, like not setting the priorities in the life properly. Somebody is spending the whole life in maybe the catching 9:50 bus, or being able to make children wake up and prepare the tiffin on time, or something like that. So we have been involved in meeting these short requirements so much, because we live so much hugely fragmented and complex life, that we have many, many things to put together. Mm-hmm. And we are always in some kind of emergency mode, and we are always searching for some short, quick fixes.
Mm-hmm.
To me, it appears that now the time for finding those short, mm-hmm. quick fixes is over.
Mm-hmm.
And we should really look deep mm-hmm. in our life, in things that what could be the long-term solutions,
mm-hmm.
how to prepare life for the long term,
mm-hmm.
and that could be done only when we just remove lot of small petty nuisances from mm-hmm. our life, mm-hmm. fragmentations from the mind.
Mm-hmm.
Now coming to your question, that what to do
mm-hmm.
as of now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, of course that is also important, and there are certain short-term measures that could be taken
mm-hmm.
so that you don't further lose your immunity, that you don't further lose your health, and you don't succumb to this infection. We got to follow all the guidelines that the WHO or your government, state, city, or country government, whoever is prescribing. They are all well researched, well meant.
Mm-hmm.
So we must be following them. Apart from that,
mm-hmm.
we have certain suggestions, and I am very confident that those suggestions are very, very strong. The first and the most important suggestion is to keep your cool.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mean that you deny this problem. I'm seeing that people are divided in two groups.
Mm-hmm.
One group is which is having a lot of scare of this disease,
mm-hmm.
lot of fear. And second is living in a denial,
mm-hmm.
that it cannot happen to me,
mm-hmm.
or it is not there.
Mm-hmm.
So I think both the approaches are wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And we should be acting upon cautiously at this point of time,
mm-hmm.
and keep our cool, but be prepared.
Mm-hmm.
Act upon.
Mm-hmm.
And the actions, as I said, whatever the agencies are recommending, apart from that, One very strong suggestion from our side is to expose yourself to sun. Mm-hmm. If possible, with no clothes mm-hmm. or with minimum clothes. Mm-hmm. And if not possible, then maybe with some clothes, try to put very thin white mm-hmm. cotton clothes, short if mm-hmm. possible.
Sunscreen?
No. We don't want to block the sun. Mm-hmm. Sunscreen is a sun blocking agent. Mm-hmm. And actually our skin is a solar panel. Mm-hmm. And we are all the time trying to cover our panel by putting on the clothes, by going indoor or by applying the sunscreen. So sun exposure is needed, and the sun can do many things. Mm-hmm. First thing that it does is sanitizes you. Mm-hmm. Sun is a wonderful sanitizer. Mm-hmm. It has certain UV rays, but of course the morning and evening suns are not good sanitizers.
Okay.
And many people think that you can take sun exposure in the morning when the sun is mild, or in the evening. That's not the right time. And also many people do Surya Namaskar indoor. That's mm-hmm. absolutely rubbish idea. Mm-hmm. Surya Namaskar has to be done outdoor mm-hmm. and ideally without clothes. Mm-hmm. So Surya Namaskaram is exposing yourself to the sun.
Mm-hmm.
Physical thing that you do, twisting, turning, is a secondary. The primary is this, that you are offering yourself to the sun.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are doing it indoor, I mean, it's not a Surya Namaskar at all.
Mm-hmm.
Take some other name. Don't call it Surya Namaskar. So it does many things. One, as I said, that it's a wonderful sanitizer, and those UV rays will kill the virus,
mm-hmm.
will denature its protein.
Mm-hmm.
So if you let the sun come to you, so you are killing your virus, mm-hmm. that is one thing. Second is this, that sun is a powerful mood elevator.
Mm-hmm.
It's anti-stress, but anti-stress doesn't seem a right word, so I what would call it a mood elevator.
Mm-hmm.
You feel good, you mm-hmm. start feeling happy, your vitamin D level goes up, your depression goes down.
Mm-hmm.
So you feel good.
Mm-hmm.
And then you also get good sleep
mm-hmm.
if you are exposed to the sun.
Mm-hmm.
And those things all put together have, if you have good sleep, then you will have good immunity.
Mm-hmm.
And if you could couple some mild physical work,
mm-hmm.
somehow I don't recommend exercises or yoga or things like that. I always think that doing some real work is not just equivalent to yoga or exercises, is 10 times more effective.
Mm-hmm.
Doing something unreal is very mechanical. So doing something real is at least 10 times more effective. So do some real work, maybe do your household thing, do some grooming, cleaning, whatever. So get your muscles moved
mm-hmm.
and that will also bring you good sleep.
Many people, their house help is not coming nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
And should you call your house help at this time? What should you do with that?
You can call your house help once
okay.
to give them some money
mm-hmm.
because they could be in a problem. So if you can give some money to your house help through electronic means, that's wonderful. If you cannot, do call them once and give them at least 2 months salary. They need money. And do all what they do by yourself. So if you are calling house help and letting the house help do all the work at home, you are increasing your risk by many, many folds. Number one, because your house help may be transmitting the virus from one home to another home. That is one thing. Second is this, that you would want to be doing the physical work.
Mm-hmm.
So it would be a huge problem. So call them once, give them money,
mm-hmm.
do your work.
Okay. And what, there is a short supply of
mm-hmm.
many things.
Mm-hmm.
Food being the topmost thing.
Mm-hmm.
So what diet, is there some diet that one can follow in this time?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, there is a shortage of supplies. And this is a wonderful time to kind of look into your food habits. Why are you eating? You might be eating, all of us eat for the nutrition, for the nourishment, but apart from that, and most people most of the time do eat because of addiction or because of boredom. You need many meals and you need a variety of food. You need keep munching something all the time just because maybe you are feeling bored or you are depressed or you are stressed.
Mm-hmm.
Or you are addicted to the food. Because food companies, even the restaurants, put their all the skills in designing food which could be addictive. And that is how they can have your loyalty. So you could be addicted to the food or you could be eating just because of boredom. So try to figure it out. Is this a real hunger or it is because of other reasons? So this is the time when you should be eating only for nutrition and not much for taste and not for boredom. There are other tools that you can use to come out of the boredom and never for the addiction.
Mm-hmm.
So eating something very simple is good. Nothing, I mean, just try to eat as bland as possible, as less spicy, as less cooked.
Mm-hmm.
And I would suggest eat the same thing every day. That will bring you out of addiction faster.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever you can cook at home, that's a good choice. One thing I would like you to add, some greens. If you are able to get some citrus fruit, it could be a good idea, because having little higher vitamin C in the times of flu does help. So oranges or anything like that, citrus fruit, pineapple or something is good. But if you cannot find them or if they are not from a trusted source, they might even carry the corona at your home. Keep in mind, even the food stuff and the fruits. So my better advice would be, grow some sprouts at home. Use mung beans or chickpea, Bengal grams or something, and grow some sprouts. Sprouts are having very high nutritional score.
Mm-hmm.
Nutritional score of mung sprouts is around 78, one of the highest score. In comparison to that, apple has got a score of only 35. So this is the huge difference. So grow some sprouts at home and eat them raw. Many people grow sprouts and then put them in a pressure cooker. And that way you spoil all the nutrition that has come up. And sprouts are also very, very rich in vitamin C. That's the advice I like to give.
Mm-hmm. So ideas that you shared about sun and
mm-hmm.
workout
mm-hmm.
and food,
mm-hmm.
sprouts,
mm-hmm.
will all of this...
I'd like to add one more thing mm-hmm. to it. The infusion of turmeric also does help. It may not act against the virus, but it does reduces the inflammation if you have anything. So maybe it does help in other kind of flus and coughs, so there will not be much confusion if you keep taking that. So prepare some infusion of turmeric. Making it is very easy. Just boil half teaspoon of turmeric in half liter of water. You can add little jaggery or tulsi leaves if you like them, and you can just sip it warm. That will also help.
So in this video, we learned about how to take care of ourselves during this time. We hope that you're following the government's advisory and you're staying in isolation. And this video was useful for you. In the next video, we'll talk about the scientific progress on the research for coronavirus and sanitizers, masks, and what other steps that we can take during this time.